Night Radio with Ashley Storrie on BBC Radio Scotland.
Listen on BBC Sounds.
Brackets single edit. You're listening to Ashley Storrie on BBC Radio Scotland live from Pacific Quay.
You're saying the quiet bit out loud.
Wait, what? What bit? The quiet. Well, the no, I'm always going to read the in brackets, Paul. You never know, it might be important. Live from Pacific Quay. We are on the final hour of the final show of 2023. I'm not well. Paul's having to do a lot of heavy lifting on this show. And keeping me on track, even
Smell,
though...
I've got my massage gun for the sore shoulders I'm going to have.
Okay, because mainly all I want to talk about is Fruit of the Loom. Now I'm convinced that I've been moved from a different universe.
Nope.
But we're not allowed to talk about that, because apparently it's boring. So we're going to talk about Adam Driver.
Big Loom have been on the phone.
Big Loom, Big Fabrics have been on the phone and said, stop talking. It's nothing to do with them. It's the Large Hadron Collider, Paul. See when the two particles got flung against each other.
Tim Berners-Lee and CERN have been on the phone. Mm-hmm. Big Science and went, shut her up.
Shut her up. She's getting too close to the truth.
Mm-hmm.
And now...
It's Brian Cox. Paul, we've told you about this.
Well, I was
keep one... her in check.
I was like, why is Brian Cox phoning you for Succession? I always get them two mixed up. Right, we've got messages in. We should read them, Paul.
We really should.
Okay, First of all, Chris and Leanne have been in touch and says, hello, you two, Chris and Leanne, listening in to a great show again. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year when it comes on Sunday. 80 Kenny Rogers roasters, yay, for Adam Driver. Leanne is not playing the game properly as she is adding 10 for cuteness. Is Adam Driver a hot man?
I think he's hot to certain people. I think he's one of these ones where he's interesting.
And I think he's more interesting.
Like, and people like, some people find that cute though.
Oh, I guess. Like, I guess cuteness is, I guess I'm thinking cute is a specific type of thing as opposed to like attractive. I can get that he's attractive because he's got an approachableness. But yeah, okay, cute. I wouldn't apply the word cute to him. Cute's for like baby pandas. And for like cats and stuff. And he doesn't fit any of that kind of cute agenda.
Yeah, but he's like a big guy. He's like 6'2", 6'3". Big guy. Was in the army.
That's not cute.
Has a big long face, a big deep voice, and yet people seem to really like him.
Hunky. Hunky's
yeah, but I don't even think he comes across as hunky. I think he seems quite approachable.
I guess. Oh, he's married. To a lady called Joanne.
Yeah, he's been married since he met her at Juilliard. Been married for a long time.
I like that. He seems like a nice, handsome guy. I just wouldn't have classified him as cute, but I think I'm being a wee bit too autistic with my definition of what cute is. Mm. I'm like, it has to be like a bunny with big ears.
He won me over. You know that bit I'm talking about? He won me over with that Q&A that he did recently, where they videoed it, and
Paul,
a man asked a question about the film Ferrari that he's in.
Paul loves nothing more than a famous person giving less than two figs about what's been said to them. It's his favourite thing. When Ridley Scott essentially said during an interview when he was told that he got his facts about Napoleon wrong, and he was like, you don't know. You weren't there.
Were you there?
Paul.
Shut up.
Was delighted. So that's his favourite thing. And Adam Driver's a bit like that. The other thing I know about Adam Driver is something I can sympathise a lot with. He hates watching himself.
Oh, he can't stand it. He won't watch himself. He's walked out of like radio interviews and stuff if they even play a clip.
But it is, I'm
the same.
Feel the same way. I hate it. And I've had to go in and do ADR, which is where you essentially like re-record the audio of what you've done, and you have to watch your face over and over and over again.
Nope.
Because like the boom mic picked up an aeroplane at the same time, and you have to re-record that one line, and it is so uncomfortable. So I don't know how he does that. I don't know how he does ADR, because you have to watch it to see your mouth move to make your voice fit in your own mouth, if that makes any sense.
I know.
But yeah, I read that about him and I was like, oh, I sympathise. We've got another message. Sherry and Sean from Georgia. Adam Driver's song was painful. Two Kenny Rogers roasters. One from each of us. Happy New Year to you and Paul. Thank you so much, Sherry and Sean from Georgia. I hope you have a lovely new year.
Well, you assumed it was that Georgia. What if it's Georgia, the country?
You're absolutely right, Paul.
I mean, it's probably not, but...
You don't know?
I don't know, exactly.
Get in touch, Sherry and Sean. Are you from Georgia, as in Atlanta? Or Georgia, the country? Let us know. It's such a stupid thing to say, Paul. Andrew Eric.
You don't know.
Andrew Eric from Paisley says, hi again, Ashley and Silent Paul. It's Andrew Eric from Paisley here again. Well, what can I say about Adam Driver and his performance on tonight's Hollywood Swingers? I had high hopes after seeing him as Enzo Ferrari this week in the Ferrari film, which I did enjoy. You said it made you feel. It made me feel too. Yes, it made me feel, what the hell is this I'm listening to? Sorry, not for me. But I was never really into musicals, although I have enjoyed them more and more in my later years. Maybe an age thing. Sorry, but it's 15 Kenny Rogers roasters from me. Okay, Andrew Eric for Paisley. Fair enough. Fair dues. Thank you so much for getting in touch. Each to their own. I'm so sorry. My medicine hasn't kicked in from the past hour yet, so I'm just now feeling really sleepy and like I need to lie down and sniff some Albus oil.
Well, why don't we give you a break then for 4 minutes and 3 seconds.
Okay.
I'm going to play another one of the songs that's been an earworm for you.
You played this earlier in the year, and ever since you did, I have listened to this song over and over and over again. I have loved it. It is such a good song. It's Sad Cafe with Everyday Hearts, and right now Everyday does hurt.